Hiya, today in this video we are going to discuss briefly about Lindlar's catalyst and Lindlar reduction. In this we are going to discuss Lindlar reduction reaction, the mechanism and examples. Before starting, if you have not subscribed this channel, please subscribe to get notified. For better understanding, please don't skip this video and watch till the end. Let's begin. Lindlar's catalyst. The Lindlar's catalyst is palladium over calcium carbonate in presence of lead oxide. You have to note that the major use of this catalyst is to reduce the alkyne to alkene in the cis position. This is the cis position, not the trans. Lindlar reduction. The stereoselective reduction of alkynes to cis alkenes by hydrogen in presence of palladium, that is tinctured into calcium carbonate, and then it is deactivated by lead acetate and quinoline. The structure of quinoline is this one. This one is quinoline. It is often known as the Lindlar reduction or Lindlar hydrogenation. The reaction. This is the alkyne, which is the starting material of this reaction. We are treating with one equivalent of hydrogen in presence of palladium over calcium carbonate and lead acetate or quinoline. The starting material is converted into cis alkene. This is cis alkene. You see, these hydrogens are in cis position. This is a stereoselective reduction which converts these alkynes into cis alkenes. Generally, an alkene will reduce to an alkane. However, this Lindlar catalyst is poison catalyst which suppresses the ability for this to readily occur. If the Lindlar catalyst is poison, the alkyne is converted to alkene. Generally, it is not converted into alkene to alkane. Let's see the mechanism. You see the palladium over calcium carbonate is here. We are adding PbOAC twice, that is lead acetate and quinoline. This is the product which obtained after this reaction. You see here palladium is substituted with the acetate group and the quinoline group. After that, the alkyne is added here. You see, this is substituted here. After that, the hydrogen is added here and the palladium is substituted with this alkene. Here already the palladium is substituted, here hydrogen is added and it is added to this alkyne, forming this alkene, which is cis position. After that, it is deactivated. This compound, this complex which is attached to the palladium, is deactivated, forming the cis alkene. This is the mechanism. The mechanism seems to be complicated, but it's very simple reaction. Let's see the examples. This is the example which is taken from Journal of Organic Chemistry. This is the starting material. You see alkene is present here. This is converted into cis alkene. This alkyne is converted into cis alkene. This is cis position. And this alkene is not converted into alkane because it is poison catalyst. Lindlar catalyst is poison. Is usually by sulfates or carbonates. By this, the Lindlar catalyst is poison, so alkynes only converted into alkenes, but not the alkenes will not convert it into alkanes. You see this example, which is taken from Organic Letters. This is the starting material. The compound is complex, but it's very simple reaction. This alkyne is converted into cis alkene. You see here only this portion, only it is converted. In this reaction, quinoline is added. This is taken from Organic Letters. And you see this example here. This is the starting material. Here the alkyne is present and the Lindlar catalyst is given. This alkyne is converted into cis alkene. Here MPMO means paramethoxybenzyl. This is the another example. You see, this is a starting material. Here alkyne is present. The Lindlar catalyst is given. The Lindlar catalyst is palladium over calcium carbonate. Pb OAC twice or quinoline. Here this alkyne is converted into cis alkene, and this alkene is not converted into alkane. This is taken from organic letters. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned until the next video. Please like this video, share and subscribe. Have a good day.